Hello everyone and welcome back to African World. Today, we have a fascinating story to share with you about a brilliant innovator whose work has reshaped the way we connect and communicate in the digital age. Our protagonist is none other than Dr. Victor Lawrence, a visionary engineer whose contributions have transformed the landscape of data transmission and the internet as we know it. Victor Lawrence's impact on technology is nothing short of remarkable. He's been a driving force behind several pivotal developments, each one pushing the boundaries of what's possible. Our journey begins with Lawrence's groundbreaking work at Bell Laboratories. He reimagined how data could travel faster and more efficiently over telephone lines. His innovations led to the birth of voice band modems and DSL technologies. But that's just the tip of the iceberg. Dr. Lawrence didn't stop there. He played a pivotal role in the development of an NT's 2.4 kbps full duplex modem, which was a game changer in its time. Thanks to his work, modem speeds surged to an impressive 56 kbps. But it doesn't end with modems. Victor Lawrence's contributions paved the way for the internet to evolve into a platform for more than just text-based communication. He pioneered methods to embed more information within signals, making digital video and radio a reality, and contributing to the rise of high definition and digital television. He has played a fundamental role in shaping the existence of tech giants like Microsoft, Apple, Zoom, Teams, Facebook, Google, FaceTime, and numerous other tech companies we see today. His technological innovations have been instrumental in propelling these companies to their current prominence. Make sure to subscribe, like, and share our videos with others. It's worth noting that the phone used by the White House and US military officials was developed by Victor Lawrence. This phone boasts strong encryption, making it extremely challenging for unauthorized individuals to eavesdrop on phone conversations. Let's now listen to Mr. Victor Lawrence as he discusses the creation of the next generation encrypted phone designed for the US defense and the White House.
Okay, yeah, say what you were saying about the development, growth of cell phones.
Yeah, because they went from the first generation to the second generation. And they also did it in such a way that a lot of things were done in the transmitters, Jesse explained to you, and the things that they used were the components that I had developed together with my colleagues. And that made the phones very small and made it very efficient. And they've gone from second generation to third generation, the fourth generation. And Jesse now, his company is working on the fourth generation.
Okay.
Yeah. So those were some of this. In between, I did a lot of other work. One of the things that I worked on was what we call the future secure voice telephone. The future secure voice telephone, using still the techniques that I had developed earlier in digital filtering, modulation, speech coding. In that time, in 1984, thereabouts, 84, 85, the US Defense Department wanted to have a generation of phones that were encrypted, a generation of phones that was digital. And so I worked on the future secure voice terminal. In fact, the terminals we built were used in the White House on the decks of the generals. Many things. And it involved just simple things like the speech. We have to digitize the speech, code it in such a way that you have it in a small number of bits, compressed it in a small number of bits, and then encrypt it. Then we had to use digital modulation to do so. So this was what really was the future secure voice terminal, FSVS. And we had the whole generation of terminals for the US government. So that was one application. Other applications was, I mentioned this speech and filtering for wireless, and then also for video as well. Those were things that we did do.
Now this is in the 80s as well?
Yeah, in the 80s.
Born in Ghana, Victor Lawrence's journey into the world of engineering began early. He earned his degrees in electrical engineering from the University of London, and today, he's a faculty member at the prestigious Stevens Institute of Technology. Beyond his technical brilliance, he's also a passionate advocate for bridging the digital divide. In conclusion, Victor Lawrence's contributions to data transmission, the internet, and global connectivity have left an indelible mark on our digital world. His dedication to bridging the digital divide is a testament to the positive impact technology can have on people's lives, no matter where they are. Although Mr. Victor Lawrence may not be a household name, we interact with his technology every single day. The next time you place a phone call, surf the web, or make a video call, take a moment to appreciate Mr. Lawrence's contributions. Africa is home to many brilliant minds, but due to inadequate leadership, their potential often remains untapped, hindering opportunities for improving our lives. If you found this video informative and inspiring, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. And as always, stay tuned for more stories of innovation and the incredible minds shaping our future.